guys, I'm just gonna tell you right now, this video isn't to brag. It isn't to show off the money I make. I save a lot of money, and this isn't from my YouTube checks. It's from side jobs and sponsorships. So let's get this video started. What's up, you guys? It's me, Aaliyah, and I'm back at it again with another video on this lovely day you're watching this. If you're new here, hi, I'm Aaliyah, like I just said. Hope you're having an amazing morning, evening, or night. Welcome to my video. If you're returning, hey, it's so good to see you back, and I hope you're also having an amazing morning, evening, or night. As you are from the title, I'll be showing you my $1,000 spring try-on haul. Like I said before, this isn't meant to brag or make fun of anyone. You guys love hauls, and you guys wanted me to do a try-on haul, so like the title says, it's try-on, and it's for spring, because spring is supposed to be coming up, but it's still cold. I don't know, but let's go ahead and get this video started with the stores that I don't really have a lot of clothes from. That makes sense. Okay, thanks, long enough intro, see you at the end. I'm sitting crisscross applesauce because this is ridiculous, but the first thing I got are these joggers. They're from the online store Cora. They're just these simple plain black sweatpants. I am going through a phase where I don't want to wear jeans at all, so I'm buying a lot of sweatpants and non-jean items. On the heel, they have like these, I don't know if you can see it on the camera, but you can see it in the try-on. They have like these little dots at the bottom on each leg, then their little logo right here, and it does have pockets. I actually have a discount code and a link if you want to get a percentage off these, any of their items. It'll be down below and the code will be on the screen. This isn't sponsored, but I do work with them. Now it's time for Forever 21. Now I'm gonna go ahead and start with accessories. I first got these black sunglasses right here. They remind me of literally just like 70s, 80s, 90s looks. I think I'm starting to finally get my style, and it's like in that era, maybe early 2000s, I'm feeling spicy. Then I also got another pair of sunglasses, also very small, very cute, with the gold frames, and they're just really cute. And then I got these fishnet leggings. I don't know why I got these. I'm gonna try to start learning how to like layer things. That could either go really good or really bad. Now moving on to clothes. First thing I got from Forever 21 is this striped black and white street. First thing I got is this black and white long sleeve striped shirt, and it's a little cropped, but I got it to the size where it covers my whole stomach because I don't really like my stomach. I always need long sleeves, so I decided, let me just go with stripes. I'm going through a stripes and like print phase, and as you can see, literally almost everything I already got is black. I have more colors coming, I promise. I also got this floral dad shirt in navy blue and white, and I love this so much. It's so lightweight and it's really not see-through at all, so you can pretty much wear anything under it with a bralette, wear it open, maybe wear it over a bathing suit and some shorts or something. And then it's just really cute and really flowy, and I love this shirt so much. It's actually ridiculous, and it's dad style. I don't know if I said that before, and I love dad style shirts, so I love being a daddy. Next thing I got this black t-shirt that has baby embroidered on it, and I just thought it was really cute because my boyfriend actually calls me baby. When he calls me my government name, I know there's something wrong, but when he calls me this, I know we're all good in the hood. So it's embroidered in three different colors, really basic, really cute. I don't know if I'm gonna wear it often because it's so basic, but I mean, it's always an option in case I have nothing to wear. Then this was like one of those items that I got because I needed to get free shipping. I don't know if I'm ever gonna wear this, I don't know if I'm ever gonna sell it, but just don't judge me, I needed the free shipping. I got this really colorful camo shirt, and when I looked at it when it came in the mail, I was like, this is a pretty bold choice of mine. I feel like it could be cute if you style it the right way. I'm gonna give it a chance. I really need to start wearing more colors, so that's the reason I got that. We're not gonna talk about it anymore. Next shirt I got was this really boxy tee. I already know I love my boxy tees. It covers my boxy body. This boxy tee has vertical stripes, and it has extra written in like calligraphy letter on the front. It reminds me so much of like vintage and 90s theme, like Fresh Prince of Bel-Air vibes. I can't believe I just said vibes, but it gives me that type of feel, like Fresh Prince, like really 90s, 80s look. And it's really cute, and I can envision this with some like jeans, maybe mom jeans, and maybe some Forces, maybe with some fishnet leggings underneath. I don't know, I have to play with it because these are all very colorful and I don't do colors, so this is very new for all of us. Next, I got this Rugrats pink crew neck because this is one of my favorite shows of all time, if you didn't know, and it's in this really light pink color. And usually Forever 21 crew necks aren't that good of a material, but this one is like pretty thick and pretty warm. The inside is really soft, and y'all, you know, pink is one of my favorite colors. colors. The word and color on this sweater is so cute, along with the little characters on the front. So you already know I had to get this. Then I kind of splurged on this sweatshirt. This is a part of Forever 21's Juicy Couture collection. It's actually this pink, blue, and white camo hoodie, like a crop hoodie. But I got it in a size medium because I don't really like crappy things, like I said. But it's just this cropped hoodie, and then it has the things on the bottom where you can pull it. Then it has Juicy on the front. It's printed on there, like laminated printed. I would think they would do like a different wording, but I mean, it's whatever. It's a really thick sweatshirt for it to be Forever 21's like line. If it was cheaper, I wouldn't have second guess getting it, but I still got it anyway, so it doesn't really matter at this point. Next thing I got was this really retro looking windbreaker. It's orange, red, blue, purple, and black. There's no hoodie on it, and it's so freaking cute. A lot of you guys were asking me where I got this sweatshirt from after I posted this video on my spam. Beat it up, then slow that shit down on the gas. Slow it down, bust it, bust down, bust it, bust it, bust down on the gas. You're welcome. This jacket is for sure from Forever 21, and I love it so much because it reminds me of like a bowling alley type of thing. So I don't know, I just really like it with like the mesh inside. It's actually like a windbreaker, so like if I wear a hoodie under here, I'm not cold at all. So props to that for actually doing what it's supposed to. Then I got another type of windbreaker. I got this members only like pullover windbreaker, and it is so cute. Baby blue is one of my favorite colors of all time. I really like the hood detailing. It has members only on there, and it's so cute, and it has like the kangaroo pouch right here. If you're going to the J. Cole Dreamville Fest, I'm gonna be there. So I mean, this is really cute for festivals. If it gets cold at night, you could just throw it on over. And then the checkerboard string is also a really nice touch, so you know, switch up like the color scheme and then also match the other color that is on the jacket. And I also got a baby blue faux leather jacket because I have no leather jackets. When I wore this in a video, you guys were like, oh my gosh, it looks like a t-shirt. So I feel like I just look so like professional in leather jackets, and there's such a cute touch to any basic outfit. I got the same leather jacket except in black, and it was actually a pretty decent price, and it's really good quality, and it's really easy to take care of. So if you're ever looking for leather jackets, definitely go check out Forever 21. So next, we're gonna head over to Dick's Sporting Goods. First thing I got was this gray Nike sweatshirt. This is one of my favorite sweatshirts of all time that I own. This has been through the wash and dryer a few times by now, and it still feels like just when I got it. The inside is just as soft, the quality is just as nice, and I would 10 out of 10 get another sweatshirt. Maybe a different color scheme, maybe a same color scheme, I don't know. Like I said, I'd get the same sweatshirt in a different color, and I sure did. I got that in black also. I don't really like the black one as much because, you know, I'm trying to get away from like dark neutral colors, but usually when it's hoodies, I pretty stay neutral so it matches everything. So yeah, I got that in black. Then I wanted to step into some new Nike territory, which is their sweatpants. I have Nike sweatshirts, shirts, shorts, but I don't have any sweatpants. I even have leggings, but I don't have any sweatpants. So I got this pair of black Nike joggers with this simple Nike embroidered sign right here. They're very thin. I think they were in the men's section, so maybe that's why they fit me the way they do. But I actually really love these, but they are very thin, so if you wear them on a cold day, you might want to wear leggings under or something. Then these are the cutest freaking sweatpants I think I own, but they're these Nike sweatpants that have Nike and like the swoosh on the side of the pant, and it's so cute. The inside is so fuzzy and so nice. These are my favorite sweatpants I've ever bought. The next store I stopped at was PacSun. I'm saying stopped at like I went out and bought all these things. I literally got all this stuff online. First thing I got was this cute plaid shirt. I got this in an extra small, and I'm so freaking happy I did. So I'll be like wearing this like every week, and this is just a really cute piece with the spaghetti straps and then like the buttons in the front, and the straps are adjustable, so I'm very happy for that. Then I got the matching shorts to get the full set, and then the shorts have like this thing that you tie around. I'm probably gonna tied in a bow, and they're just so freaking comfortable. And I don't really like form fitting shorts because I don't like my legs. I feel like they are too skinny because a lot of people tell me all the time they are too skinny. Next thing I got is another long sleeve, more stripes. You don't know how I feel about stripes. I got this navy blue, baby blue, and white striped crew neck. Now this one is way thinner than the one from Forever 21, but I still love it because it's really cute. I'm really into blue right now because I wore some blue item, I think, in some video if I remember properly, and it was just a really good feedback from you guys, like, oh my gosh, you should wear blue more. So I was like, okay, let me just keep buying blue. Then I'm trying to get into more like skirts, so excuse this little phase. But then I got this tan and white plaid skirt. Now if I knew it was gonna be this big, I would have gotten an extra small instead of a small, because if you didn't know, I'm not the thickest person out there. My waist is actually very tiny. It fits my waist perfectly and my stomach perfectly, but my thighs and butt it does not. So I'm probably just gonna have to either put on some weight or trade it in for an extra small. But I mean, this skirt's actually really cute. It's really nice material and I love it so much. I always said I would never get this brand, but it was on sale. So when you see the price, don't freak out. I got this Kappa crop hoodie. Now, I don't know what I was thinking when I put this in my cart, because literally it's a long sleeve jacket and it's cropped to literally right under the boot. So I don't know if I'm gonna be hot or cold when I wear this. It was cute, so I got it, and it was $20 less than what it actually was. So if you're gonna attack me for how much it cost, just leave it alone. And it has like the logo down the side and it has it on the front and it's like embroidered in there. Now on to Brandy Melville. Brandy Melville is very overpriced. I'm probably never gonna get anything from there ever again unless it's jewelry or accessories. First thing I got from Brandy was this Brooklyn sweatshirt. It's black on black embroidered, so it's kind of hard to see right now, but you'll see it in the try on portion, of course. And it's just this Brooklyn NYC sweatshirt. It's really oversized, but it's like the perfect amount of oversized. Then I got this white tube top, because I don't have a white tube top, surprisingly. I have gray and that's it. So I decided to get a white one, and I wear this thing literally religiously. It fits perfectly. And then these jeans kind of baffled me, because on the website they sell these jeans. These are their mom jeans, by the way. They sell them in small, medium, large. I got a small, and these are some of the weirdest jeans I have. They look really cute and really good, but when I tell you my waist is cinched and snatched to the freaking god, like literally I can't bend over to tie my shoe while these are buttoned and zipped because they're so tight. I mean, it fits my leg length perfectly, but the waist, it just needs a little bit bigger. These are really cute, but I wish they had more size availability in the store and better ways for you to figure out what's your size. Then I was being kind of bold when I got this. I got this tan corduroy jacket. It's actually really freaking cozy. It has like that teddy bear jacket material on the inside, except this is actually soft, and it's really warm and it looks really good if you style it properly. Now it's time for Urban Outfitters. I found myself at Urban Outfitters a lot in the sales section and sometimes not in the sales section, if we're being honest. I got these small hair scrunchies. You know, like every basic YouTuber has these, because I mean, they're good for curly hair because they don't damage it as much as regular hair ties do. They came in this assortment of 5 and they're really cute, and I wear these all the time when I want to do like my puffs on top of my head because they don't pull my hair too much and they never give me a headache. Then I got this black belt because, like I said early in the video, I'm not the thickest and I really need to start wearing belts to keep my pants up so I'm not pulling them up every 5 seconds. And then Urban Outfitters always has bomb skincare sales, so they had their 2 for $5 like sheet mask. So I went ahead and got the hydrating I'm lavender, the green tea skin purifying clear skin rice, and then the nourishing honey mask. Urban, you're doing great, sweetie. Oh, one more accessory. And I went ahead and got this mini really cute plaid bag. I don't know why I've been so into like plaid lately. I feel like I'm in middle school again. But I feel like this is really cute, really vintage like, and it's really small and cute. I could pretty much fit everything I need in here. It's like my phone, vlog camera, maybe a mini tripod, chapstick, lip gloss, wallet. And I love how it has like the crossbody option, but also the two little handheld things right here. I'm not putting these shoes on my bed. They're in my lap, okay? So now, I usually don't get shoes often, but when I do, they're either really cheap or I really like them. And I got these because I really like them. And I'm really getting tired of Vans, if you haven't noticed. I've been trying to avoid wearing Vans because I'm sick of them. I will still wear them and I still love them, but I'm tired of wearing them all the time. So I decided to switch it up a little bit. First pair of shoes I got were these baby blue New Balances. And when I tell you these are my freaking babies, I mean that. They're so cute and they remind me so much of spring, and I've been fiending to get my hands on some New Balances because I've always seen really cute pairs and I feel like no pair was ever just made for me, but these were made for me, I swear. They're so cute and so comfortable and I love these so much, but they are suede so I have to take really good care of them, and these are just my babies. I love them so much. I got these gray Birkenstocks. Sorry, that was backwards. I got these gray, like, plasticky Birkenstocks because, one, they were on sale once again. These are actually really cute and really cozy. I'm trying to get comfortable with my toes and feet, and I feel like since these have, like, the two things over the foot, I'm gonna be more comfortable showing, like, toes as long as they're done. But these are actually really cute, and I don't regret getting these one bit. Last pair of shoes I got are these gray Reeboks. Once again, kind of going back to the neutral root, but there are hints of navy blue and white in them. And once again, these are really freaking comfortable. You don't need expensive shoes to be comfortable. These weren't even over $100. I don't even think they were $75, but these were so worth it and I love these so freaking much because these are kind of like different, but they're kind of still cute. So it makes me feel really good when I wear them. Now it's time for clothes. First thing I got from Urban was this really gray slouchy sweater. It's really thin. It's not really meant to keep you warm because like who wants to get a sweater this thin that will keep you warm? Really like that destroyed look, like the hemline and fringy and things like that. Then I got this flannel because it was on sale, and this flannel actually really goes good with those mom jeans that I got from Brandy Melville. I've worn that outfit before and I feel like those two are just like a really good combination. So then I also got this plain white t-shirt in a medium because in the picture it had somebody tying a knot in them, and I feel like if I was gonna tie a knot I want it to be a little big, so it's it's not like cinching my waist and like suffocating me. Really cute, really basic. I don't really have white t-shirts that are like that material, so I love it a lot. And then I got this Looney Tunes long sleeve, and I've been wanting Looney Tunes shirts because, you know, I've just like, I've never watched it until I started getting the shirts, and I literally love it. And it just has Looney Tunes on the side with the family characters on the front. Now onto bottoms. I got these green Adidas, like really thick sweatpants. Now you're probably like, why'd you get green? You don't really like green. Green is like growing on me, and this isn't like bright green, but these are like a really nice darkish forest green. I love that a lot. And they're really thick. They're almost as thick as my Champion sweatpants that I got a while back, but they're really nice, and I love Adidas sweatpants because they fit me so nicely, like around my waist. And they're actually one of the only sweatpants that fit my thighs and my hips because they're so different. Now, sinking back into my skirt fetish, I got another freaking plaid skirt. This one also doesn't really fit my butt the way I want it to. I want it to be more form-fitting, but it's still kind of loose. And I love these so much because they're really freaking comfortable. Then I got these plaid trouser pants, but these fit me so well. I love these so freaking much. So if I ever need to dress up, I definitely wear these. And they have pockets. What dress pants do you know that has decent form-fitting pockets? Because I don't know any besides those. Then I went ahead and snagged these Adidas shorts because I don't have any workout shorts. I have Nike Pros, but they don't let your cooter cat breathe. I love these so much. They're good for sleeping, working out, going on a walk, going on a run, going out to a quick IHOP trip. I don't know. They work for everything. I got these black distress shorts from Urban Outfitters, and they're really cute. They're high-waisted. They are pretty short, but the way I'm probably gonna wear them, they're probably gonna look actually normal length. Then I also got these vintage looking shorts. They are loose. They don't squeeze my butt and thighs to make it look like I have nothing. I usually get my pants a size up because when I wash them, they always shrink. I haven't really had that experience with these yet, so I mean, they're probably gonna shrink over time, but these are really cute. Then I got these distressed regular fit Levi jeans. Really cute. Once again, not tight at all. Super lightweight, and they're Levi. Pretty decently priced for some Levi shorts, so I'm not mad about it. And then this is these light wash jeans with little distress marks on them. Not too much. So I love the distress look and the old vintage look, but not too much to where it looks too modern. Then I got these darker wash jeans because I do not have any darker wash mom jeans, so I decided this would be good to add to my collection. Once again, size 25. And these have more obvious distress marks like right here on the leg. And I think that's the only major one besides like on the sides and everything. Going through a mom jean phase. If you know what my style is turning into, please tell me because I don't know. And then Dope sent me a package full of freaking goodies, and I can't thank them enough for sending me this stuff. They didn't tell me I had to share this on social media, but I decided to because they were so sweet to send me these things. Dope, thank you again so much if you're watching. If you don't follow my Dope, go ahead and follow it. They sent me these freaking Topshop SpongeBob socks I've been wanting for so freaking long because they looked at my stuff and they actually care about me. Like, guys, I've been wanting these for so freaking long. Like, oh my God. And then they sent me these sunglasses that I also had in my accessories folder slash like save things I want. They're from Urban Outfitters. So freaking cute. Been wanting these for so long. Then they sent me a bunch of skincare stuff. They sent me these Glam Glow Hydrating Treatment and Water Burst little mini packets of skincare. I think they're like little things you put on your eye. I don't know if it's a peel off. I haven't done these yet, but they're really hydrating, and my skin has been really dry lately. I'm not sure why, but I can't wait to use those. Then they sent me this Mario Badescu Acne Starter Regimen Kit that I've had in my skincare wands for so freaking long. I love Mario Badescu stuff. Even if I don't have acne, this stuff works amazing if you want any decently priced skincare stuff that are kind of high in named but not high in price. Then Dope decided to send me some products that I have been fiending for over a year now and was never able to get it because of how expensive it was. If you've seen these in Sephora and Ulta, you know they're not cheap, and I cannot once again thank them enough. Dope decided to send me the Glam Glow Glitter Mask, and it literally makes your skin feel so freaking good. I don't know what I did to deserve this. They're such good people. They work so hard to keep all the people that use their app happy, and I can't thank them enough for this. And they also sent me another Glam Glow product. It is their Volcasmic Matte Glow Moisturizer, and I have always wanted to try this because I have oily skin most of the time, combination if you want to get technical. And for them to go out and go through my list and actually pick these things to send to me for hitting 21k, I don't know what to do. But guys, I really appreciate it, and I really love them so much. So if you don't, go ahead and follow me on Dope. This isn't sponsored, but they're supporting me, so I'm gonna support them. But guys, that is it for my $1,000 spring try on haul. This wasn't meant to hurt anybody's feelings or brag. If you got that from me, I'm sorry. I collected this over the past 3-5 months, so I didn't spend this all at once. But if you like the video, please give it a huge thumbs up down below, and while you're down there, make sure you subscribe to my channel. Comment down below what your type of style is and what my my type of style is going like to be, because I would love to know. Make sure you follow my socials. That includes my Instagrams, Twitter, and Snapchat, so you can keep up with me when I'm not on camera. So guys, that is it for today's video, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye.